Hey guys, how's everyone doing? So the spring 2000 anime season is currently underway. You know, most shows have had their first episode already, and I'm a little behind, and when I say a little, I actually mean a lot, but I finally managed to watch a couple of episode ones for the anime that have debuted, and today I'm gonna have a couple of first episode reviews for the anime that I have watched. So today, right now, we're gonna be discussing Flying Witch, which is so charming, relaxing, and just so fun, and it's by JC's staff. I originally wanted to watch Flying Witch because I like witches on brooms and black cats and stuff like that. I like that kind of stuff. You know, it reminds me of Halloween and that's my favorite holiday, so I love that kind of stuff. I was like, this is a show that I'm definitely gonna check out, and I watched the first episode. We really see this girl named Makoto, and she is a witch. She basically turned 15, and it's tradition to, you know, get out of your house and become independent. You're an adult at 15, so you gotta get out, and that's exactly what she did. She moved, and now she's going to be living with her second cousin. She's going to be freeloading, basically. That's how her cousin Kay tells his sister Chinatsu. He's like, she's going to be freeloading. I'm like, that's usually not a good thing. He should have introduced her in a different way, not like, oh, she's a freeloader. That's what he made it sound like. Basically, she's going to be living at his house, and she's going to, you know, do her witch things and attending his school as well. So she's attempting to live, you know, a regular normal life, as well as, you know, doing what she does as a witch. So that's really cool, and I liked seeing how Chinatsu at first, she's like, oh, who is this, and whatever, but they eventually go shopping together. You know, her and Makoto, they go shopping and they have like a great time, and they go look at donuts, and I'm like, ah, because I like donuts. They eventually go to a place that's selling brooms, and Makoto, you know, since she's a witch, she's like, oh, I could buy a broom. So she tests out a bamboo broom, and she ends up levitating. And Chinatsu has like this hilarious expression on her face because she's like, what is going on? And the next thing you know, like a couple of minutes later, Chinatsu's on the broom too, and they're flying, and she's having like the best time ever. She's just so happy, and anything that she felt before about Makoto is like completely erased, because now she's just like, wow, that was awesome. They weren't like flying like miles away or anything, but just like flying, you know, woohoo. I loved seeing the interaction between Makoto and Chinatsu, because now I think that right there was like a bonding experience, because now I think Chinatsu really likes Makoto, and yeah, it's really, really cool. We eventually see Kay again at his friend's store. Her parents own a liquor store, and I forgot her name. I think her name is Nao or something. Nao? We see her again when Makoto goes to school, and Nao's like, you know, don't do all that witch stuff here because people aren't used to it. And I got this sense of jealousy from her, because I think that Nao is jealous of her since Makoto is living with Kay, and I thought that maybe Nao likes Kay. So we don't know that yet, but I don't know. I got this like jealousy vibes from her. They end up becoming like a little bit of friends, I think, in a way, because eventually, you know, Nao walks Makoto home, and of course Makoto likes to do weird things. You know, to her it's not weird, this is just witch things, but you know, for everyone else it's like, what are you doing? So Makoto ends up finding like a mandrake, and she tries to pull it out, and she yanks it out eventually, and the thing is screaming, and it looks like a cactuar. Like, am I the only one who thought it looked like a cactuar? I probably am. It totally looked like one, and it was like screaming, and it was funny, and it was very, very different, and I just really enjoyed the first episode of Flying Witch. I thought it was relaxing, I thought it was calming. It's definitely not, you know, like fast-paced or anything, but it's very, very relaxing and very, very enjoyable to watch. The comedy is great, the atmosphere is great, I love the art, the animation, the scenery is gorgeous. I love where they live. It's very, very, very rustic and very peaceful. So I like that, and I really enjoy the first episode of Flying Witch. I definitely recommend it if you like slice of life or things about, you know, witches, but like kind of like Kiki's in a way. It's really, really adorable. I enjoyed it. There's comedy in there, and it's just a lot of fun despite, you know, not too much going on, but it's just nice to watch. It's peaceful, and it's definitely something that I will be watching this season because I like that kind of stuff. This is something like amidst all of the, you know, action series and horror or mysteries, you have like this peaceful series, and it's good. It's good for the soul. So I like stuff like that. If you watched episode one of Flying Witch, let me know in the comments, what did you think about Flying Witch? But yeah, that's what I thought, and I hope you enjoyed this review. Thanks for watching. Totally appreciate it. Please like, share, subscribe, subscribe if you liked this video, and I will see you guys next time. So today, we're gonna have a manga haul, which I haven't done in a while, and I was actually gonna film this next week, but I was